you want to go ahead and ring the doorbell? Okay.
My name is Misty. This is my daughter, Breeland, and we're from Pennsylvania.
I am so nervous.
I'm not sure if I believe in mediums. My heart wants to believe that we can connect with our loved ones. Sometimes my head's not always in agreement.
Breeland, nice to meet you. Thank you for coming.
Dress.
Oh, thank you.
Hi, I'm Misty.
Nice to meet you, Misty.
Nice to meet
Come
you.
Come on in. Welcome to my home.
I'm nervous. I'm anxious. I'm excited to get started and hopefully get some answers to my questions.
Have you guys ever been to a medium before?
No.
Okay.
No.
Did your dad have a pinky ring? They show me a square ring. It almost kind of looks like a cuff link where it would be square, like that kind of.
Yeah, did have a ring like that.
Only because I couldn't separate the souls when they started to come forward, whether if it was a father or it was a son. What they did was come through together. Because that was one of your questions, is that you just wanted to know if your son was at peace and if he was with your father.
Absolutely.
So you know that they are together.
My son Dylan passed away 2 years ago. Him and my dad were very, very close. And one of the main questions that I felt that I needed answered was, he with my dad? Because Dylan always wanted to be with family. It's just amazing to know that he's with my father.
My brother Dylan and I were very close. We were only 13 months apart in age, so when we were very, very small, we were the best of friends, and we just kind of had our own little language together, so I miss my brother every day.
He keeps showing me this gray sweatshirt, and there's almost like an outline of a dog's face. Was there something about, you know that show on Animal Planet, Pitbull and Parolees?
Oh my God.
Pitbull and Parolees?
That's a wow. Because that is where his money went. When they ask at the funeral, did we want, you know, they always say, do you want to
I mean, he used to watch
cancer?
That all the time.
And he had pit bulls, so.
Donations to his funeral went to the pit bull rescue.
To validate that he knows.
My brother was an animal lover, so it's really nice to have validation that he sees the things that we've done in his honor.
It was just amazing for her to bring up something so obscure as that.
I was made to feel that you're very angry. Spirit has told me how you feel. You feel that your brother was left to die.
Exactly.
Because he keeps showing me the car, but then I see people around. And it's almost like, how can nobody know what happened? That's crazy.
That is exactly true. He was at a party with friends, and he was ready to go, and he got in the car, and he sat down in the car.
How do you connect with the number three? Were there three people in the car?
Yes.
Do you know? He said they left me in the car. They left me in the car.
You're absolutely right.
He said they didn't know that I died.
They thought he just passed out. I've been angry pretty much ever since he passed away. Angry at the people that were there, and there was a hospital three blocks away. Everyone had my number. I just didn't understand how it could go from just being at a cookout to him being dead.
Your son said, Mom, this was an accident. You understand that?
I do.
He says, I drank before. The only difference is, though, I died that night.
That's absolutely true. They were all drinking. Dylan passed away from a mixed combination of prescription medication and alcohol. He, you know, was drinking, and he shouldn't have been drinking with the medication.
He said, my sister is not living her life. You understand that?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You're gonna get your daughter back today. That's what I heard.
Thank you.
He said, you carry a survivor's guilt, that if you were there, you would have been able to save him.
I should have been there, because he invited me to the cookout, and I had to work, so I didn't go. And then I got that last phone call at 10 o'clock before I went to sleep. He said, hey, I'm just calling to let you know I'm okay and I love you. And then he passed away at 12 midnight. So it was definitely unexpected.
He says, can you please let this session rescue you? The same way that your brother made choices that night, you have a choice. He doesn't want you to feel guilty about embracing life, smiling, and doing things that you enjoy to do. Your brother is with you. And that soul bond that you share with him will never be broken.
Before this reading, I just felt like I've been carrying around guilt and anger, and you know, he helped to relieve that some today.
Good luck to you. Thank you so much.
Just a chance to get to talk to him was just amazing, so.
Thank you so much for coming.
I wish you all the best. Take care.
One of the first questions is when people meet me is, where's Larry? It's not, where's my grandmother?
Yeah.
It's my father. Where's Larry?
Where's Larry? Makes sense. It's like you're supposed to be
where's
together.
Larry? People yeah. expect that. I think we could do a book. You know how they do a Where's Waldo?
Where's Larry?
Yes, I could do a Where's Larry book and then like do all these different scenarios.
Yeah, Larry's off somewhere getting fresh.
Yeah, getting fresh.
Getting a fade.
Getting a fade in the bathroom. So today I'm meeting up with my brother Mike and my niece Hallie for soccer practice.
Go. Yes, Angelina, good job. Come on, Caitlin.
I mean, this is a really cool challenge to be able to teach my niece and her teammates some really cool moves. Gandhi, you ready?
Oh, Christian Louboutin makes soccer cleats now?
I hate to break the news to you.
Did you really bring oranges?
I brought oranges. Listen, these kids today, all they drink are these electrolyte waters that end up giving them cramps. Oranges quenches your thirst, no cramps.
Quickly, find Bella, find Bella! Get forward, put pressure, 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 pressure.
Hustle, hustle, hustle!
Let's work, let's work.
Come on, Jenna, get those legs in there, Jenna! Yeah!
Oh, boy.
Hi.
You're very good. My kids are grown, so to be able to watch my niece Hallie is amazing. And honestly, I miss going to the baseball games on the weekends, traveling for gymnastic meets. That was our life.
Knock them dead. Go ahead. This is a little too much for me. I used to play soccer, but it's very different.
Oh, yeah.
You gotta get out there.
I was gonna try to give some girls some pointers. Feeling a little intimidated.
He's trying to show
I'm
you
feeling
moves
I'm
out
feeling
there.
Nervous. I don't even know if you know what I do, but I'm a medium, which means that I'm able to connect with people that have crossed over. And when I start to feel physical things, it means that somebody would like to take an opportunity to step forward to talk about what they went through in the end of their life. And I kept feeling this in here, this pit, and then up in here. You understand that?
That's my dad.
How do you connect with the number 5?
My parents have 5 children.
He said, you connect, though, with the Red Cardinals with your dad?
All the time, and I was a cheerleader, and my team was the Cardinals.
Oh, shut up. Perfect.
I just showed her a picture.
She just showed us her cheerleading
2 minutes
picture.
Ago, Elmont Cardinals.
So weird.
When Teresa came over and did this reading, and she mentioned the Cardinals, we were all blown away. Me and the other moms were completely blown away. Teresa could not have known that I was a cheerleader on the Elmont Cardinals. That was just amazing.
But did your dad always complain about his stomach?
Yeah, he passed from ulcerative colitis.
Your father says, you can't heal from my departure because you keep going back and saying, I should have been a better daughter.
I just said this to my brother this morning. We rehashed the whole thing and I said there were so many different things I wish I did.
My dad started to become sick and I wish that I was a little bit more knowledgeable of his disease. And I would know what to expect. I felt guilty because I did not know that my dad would pass from this, and that was a complete shock to me.
You also feel that your father's passing could have been prevented.
I really do.
You want to sit there and beat yourself up.
I do.
He said, how would you help me if I wasn't even telling you what was going on? And he says, I kept you all at a safe distance.
Did.
He goes, I wouldn't even tell them I was going
it's
to the
true.
Doctor.